Hello, all. Good morning. Travis Dampier with Travis Dampier Ministries, Disciple of the Lord Jesus Christ. It is Sunday, May 30th, and right now we are waiting in anticipation to see if the Enoch calendar, you know, one that our brother Steve, his last name's not coming to me right now, Steve Fletcher, our brother Steve Fletcher had given to us. But we don't know who whose Enoch calendar it was. But either way, it was a drawn up Enoch calendar that it was Pentecost during this time right now. So we're watching. This is also 3 days from IR 14. You mean where the flood took place? You know what I mean? So we're looking at that. And then what is also happening is, of course, the UFO stuff, their release at June 1st. We just saw with the two Benjamins that didn't make it with Netanyahu and the other guy and the prophecy that the Israeli prophet has given, Kaduri. So we see all of this happening right now. So it is high watch time. Today and tomorrow, honestly, it's getting to the point now. It's high rapture watch time from now until that annular solar eclipse. You know what I mean? That's what we got to look at. There's so many things pointing to that. But yesterday, it was felt like kind of like an eerie silence. So I feel like today we're going to see some powerful things. And Lord willing, let us go be the powerful thing. All right, that's what we're waiting for. All right, but let's get to what took place yesterday. So NASA confirms the powerful CME that's coming out Earthbound. We thought it may hit yesterday. I didn't see too much yesterday. Usually it takes about 48 hours. So most likely it's going to come today. So we should be seeing a 1-2 punch, you mean, coming soon. Sister Barbara of God's Hiller 7, goodness gracious, man, this prophecy was serious, man. The Lord said the reapers are ready to bundle the tares, but he protects his own. Oh, goodness. So the wheat harvest is about to commence, and the tares have been identified and will be thrown into tribulation to be tried by fire, I believe. But I may be wrong. You know, I'm thinking the Lord is going to throw them into tribulation, but if you read the verse, man, Matthew 13:27, so the servants of the owner came and said to him, sir, did you not sow good seed in your field? How then does it have tares? He said to them, an enemy has done this. The servant said to him, do you want us then to go and gather them up? But he said, no, lest while you gather up the tares, you also uproot the wheat with them. Let both grow together until the harvest. And at the time of the harvest, I will say to the reapers, first gather together the tares and bind them up in bundles to burn them, but gather the wheat into my barn. So that's a serious verse. Like, I know I've heard other prophetic messages, Edward Upling and others said, you know, I'm going to snatch them in my hand and I'm going to throw them into tribulation. That's why I'm assuming that that's what that means, but The Bible doesn't say that. The Bible says, dude, I'm going to gather up the tares. So those that have been implanted in the church on purpose, you know what I mean? By the enemy, you know what I mean? Mockers and scoffers and those that the enemy has planted specifically to drag people down. Lord says, dude, he's going to gather them up first, dude. Sounds like he's going to throw them straight into hell instantly. So it sounds like just being on with the wheat and the tares. From my perspective, and put it in the comment section if you think it's different, because I was searching all over yesterday trying to really get some understanding around this. I'm like, Lord, like, really? Like, you're going to just grab them and throw them straight into hell? Like, they don't even get a chance to go through tribulation? And he didn't give me any word to dispute it. I asked him, I said, well, I thought you're just going to throw them in the tribulation. I thought that's what happens. But he wouldn't answer. And it was just like, and then I said, so you're telling me like that's going to happen? And he just didn't say anything. Like, so I'm like, Lord, like, wow. So this is serious, man. This is serious. And, you know, then you got to identify the tears, because I always thought the tears were the lukewarm. You know what I mean? And, you know, so I honestly, like I said, comment on it, because, you know what I mean? Like, I assume, but then I've heard others saying that the tares, they believe, are like some of the pastors that are teaching, you know what I mean, the false teaching and stuff. You know what I mean? So while it may seem they get raptured, a lot of them, you know what I mean, that have been luring people astray will get taken and then just thrown into hell. You know what I mean? Or you got the lukewarm, and it's a little bit deeper than the lukewarm. You know what I mean, right? This is the enemy has planted the tares. So there are people in the church, Satan loyalists that, you know what I mean, are in the church pretending, you know what I mean, literally, in order to lure people astray. So if we take that definition of the tares, that Satan loyalists are in the church, literally there to distract and to pull people away, I believe that. Then I believe that, yes, the Lord will go and snatch them up first, and then just toss them straight into hell for what they've done. You know what I mean? So, but the lukewarm, I truly believe, are going to be in tribulation with the rest of the unbelievers. But man, you go read that verse, man. I can't dispute what the Lord says, but I know there's other things. You know what I mean? The Lord says, I will spit you out of my mouth if you're lukewarm. But I was assuming, right, that means at death when you go. Or when it's like fourth time to meet them, like, that's a strong prophetic word, man. Put it in the comment section. Like I said, I can't dispute the word. I mean, and the word says that he's going to throw the tares in the hell. Now, so now we need to go, what is the definition of the tares? I know he separated the sheep from the goats, dude. He's getting the winnowing fork, dude. But I'm like, dude, there ain't no lukewarm on earth, Lord. Who's going to make it? Like, because there's supposed to be a multitude. And that's why I feel like it's the lukewarm. So anyway, I'm going to stand right now, you know what I mean, and say that the tares are Satan loyalists in the church, you know what I mean, that are pulling people away with an agenda. Because the enemy planted them. You know what I mean? So if the enemy plants something, that means that they are literally loyalists or reporting to Satan. So I'm going to assume it's them. So let's stick on that. And the Lord is saying, we've already marked them. We know who they are. We're going and we're going to toss them straight into the lake of fire. They're going in. And then the Lord says, I'm gathering up the rest. But that was a prophetic message saying he's already labeled them. The Lord ain't sitting around waiting no more. So, dude, that even shows again how close we are. He's already putting the labels on them. That means, dude, there's no time to repent. He's not going to go weeks and weeks and months out. You know what I mean? Of course, he already knows who's going to repent and who's not. But still, it would make sense that way, dude. That's how close we are. That's how close we are. Hey, man, I'm excited. Over in Denmark, man, the Danish government on Friday presented its digital coronavirus passport, enabling people to travel abroad or in Denmark to go to the hairdresser, a tattoo parlor, dine inside a restaurant, or wherever else it is needed. The corona passport we present today can be used from July 1 when you can travel within the EU, said Finance Minister Nikolai Vammen. So you see it already more, especially in the UK. They are pushing the passport hard. Dude, Israel already got it. All of the rest of the countries around the world are going to have it. The United States, you know, was pretending that they weren't, trying to say they weren't going to discriminate against those that didn't have the vaccine. And now they're like, oh, well, we're strongly considering it. We're looking into it for travel abroad. That's all. For travel abroad. Not here. Come on, you're going to be free. Just take it. Come on, take it. I mean, Satan and his lures are just amazing, but that's what he's doing. You see that little, small little girl on the side? That girl looks like she's about 6 years old. You see her? She's really small, right next to the beacon there, where the red arrow is. I'm going to read Ephesians 5:11. And have no fellowship with the unfruitful works of darkness, but rather expose them. For it is shameful even to speak of those things which are done by them in secret, but all things that are exposed are made manifest by the light, for whatever makes manifest is light. So the Nephilim and the Satan loyalists, you know what I mean, they love pedophilia. They love doing just nasty stuff. It's so nasty, the Lord has put a veil over our eyes for what is being done. He doesn't want us to talk about it because it's so evil, but they do some really evil, nasty stuff. Biden was sitting in the middle of a speech, turns around and starts just flirting with this little girl. Turns around, like, ooh, look at those little hair things in your head. Ooh, and look at you. You look like you're 19 years old with your legs crossed up and stuff. And we're like, what in the world is he doing? But this is what they do. Sick, sick puppy. And those of you that are admiring this sickness, this is why the Lord is going to strike down Babylon. You know what I mean? And what they taught the rest of the world and all of the stealing of children and the things that they're doing with demonic worship and stuff. The Lord sees it all. He's done with it. He's done with it. It's time. As I stated, the Pentagon's UFO report definitely should be kicking off, you know, the great deception. So we know that's coming. But they can't have a great deception unless we're gone. That's what we're talking about here. So information related, but let me get deeper into this. Information related to a former UFO researcher finding Jesus and how Jesus revealed to him that the aliens he was after were really demons from the Bible. And then this guy, so he was a UFO researcher. And he went, Tim Foster actually shared this, my brother Tim Foster in Christ. But there was a UFO researcher, and it's an amazing salvation story. But he didn't know who Christ was, didn't know any of that. And so he was trying to dig deep into the UFOs and stuff. And then he started digging up information. Then he went to a Pentagon friend, like trying to do more research. Said, dude, I'm finding more out. And then the Pentagon buddy of his said, look, you need to stop looking. And then, I mean, in a serious way, said, you need to stop looking at this stuff. And then he's like, what do you mean I need to stop looking at this stuff? And he's like, look, man, have you read your Bible lately? A Pentagon guy telling another guy at work, saying, have you read your Bible lately? Because they know that it's fallen angels. They know these are demonic, you know what I mean, entities. So that was one guy that was telling that story. And then another guy was doing like a lot of research and stuff. And then he found the Lord, and they were watching some video, and the Lord gave him a vision of, like, you know, the aliens that they always show us. But then that alien morphed into this demonic looking thing. The Lord gave him a vision while they're looking. He stopped in the middle of the video while they were all watching, and he told the rest of the UFO researchers, that, dude, I've been in this business too long. The Lord just showed me something and showed me exactly what the aliens are. I'm done. I'm quitting. So he quit his job in research, but then the Lord pulled him back and stuff. So it's and this is real testimony. This is not figurative. So it is very evident. You know what I mean? And many of us know that these are fallen angels. But the lure that Satan is doing and has been doing with children and all of us all this time, you know what I mean, trying to make monsters friendly is so that they can begin to walk on earth and begin to lure people in so they can have an open door to possess them and stuff. When you think about Sesame Street and you see all these Elmo characters and they're all monsters. They sing monster songs. It's crazy. And every cartoon, majority of them, they're all monsters. And I go, why is it that all of the cartoons, they're monsters? I didn't even realize this back in the past, but now that with my eyes open, I go, oh, Satan's been luring us from the gate. You know what I mean? He wants to make demons friendly. He wants to make scary movies friendly and fun. Oh, it's fun to get scared. Oh, it's fun to get drunk and wasted and then go watch a scary movie. Yeah, come on. so that way they can have an open door, dude, and they can penetrate you. You know what I mean? Like, this is the objective. They don't have any bodies, man. You know what I mean? They need bodies. They need to possess bodies. They want to walk around just like you do. So they're doing everything in their power to get bodies to walk around. And when you lay your life down, getting the mark of the beast, so you have a permanent open door in you because of all the mega chips and all that, and they can actually make spiritual natural and actually make you operate the way that they want to, literally, dude, you are a zombified body getting ready to be penetrated. That's exactly what is happening today. Man, the Lord says, man, he's going to show signs in the sun, moon, and the stars, man. This is amazing. Creating one of the most spectacular and surreal scenes in recent times, a blazing meteorite unexpectedly fell from the sky and crashed smack dead in the middle of Indonesia's Mount Merapi volcano. It's like a billion trillion to one chance. The historical event occurred on May 27th when it was caught on CCTV camera at Mega Data Facility in Kalatanga Kadol, Indonesia, Yogyakarta, which is where the mountain is located. Luckily, at the same time, a local Indonesian identified as Guanto Song was also taking photos of Mount Merapi volcano and caught the meteor in all its glory. Dude, look at this. Dude, that's amazing, dude. The meteor straight down in the sucker. What is going on? But I also was like, man, Lord, you're turning volcanoes on. If you don't think that's going to cause an eruption, dude. I mean, forget, like, if you would think, like, molten lava, you know what I mean, or whatever, probably is, like, hard at the surface, and underneath all the lava is really there, a meteorite, oh, that will break that. I mean, instantly magma will be ready to come out soon. So I definitely expect to see something come out of that volcano in due time. Okay, let's get to the verse of the day. Here we go. It is Psalm 56:4. Psalm 56:4. Here we go. In God, whose word I praise, in God I trust and am not afraid. What can mere mortals do to me? Oh, they can't do a thing. All right. It's actually not that long. You know, I'll leave it there. I'm not going to, you know what I mean, go deep into it. But this is where we stand today. You need to find out where your loyalty is. You know what I mean? To the world or to God? I've given some background, you know what I mean, a little bit in the past on what the Lord did when I first started ministering last year. First, what I was doing, he had me share my prophetic dream that the Lord gave me regarding the rapture. So I did that. You know what I mean? That's the first thing. And then this is where he told me, he said, well, start doing the verses of the day and just talk about it. He said, I'll lead you. I'll speak for you. Just turn it on. Look at Bible Gateway and then just start ministering. And then it started turning into share what's happening, share what you're looking at. Because the Lord has put it in my heart, you know what I mean, to make sure that those that are watching know what's around them and see the evidence, you know what I mean, so they can turn back on and wake up. So I've been doing that, you know what I mean? But at first I was sharing everywhere except my LinkedIn, you know what I mean? Because, you know, LinkedIn is supposed to be for work, right? So I was like, oh, well, they don't want to hear that. That's the business area. I need to stay away from the business area because they don't want it. I don't want to disturb them. And it's just not the proper thing. And the Lord was like, proper to who? Proper to them or proper to me? Do you think I care, Trev? Are they more valuable? Are they not valuable to you? You know what I mean? Or is it the fact that I'm not valuable enough for you to tell them? And I said, Lord, you know that I don't care. Like, I mean, you've done more than enough for me. You know what I mean? I don't care. You mean what they think about me? I have never cared. But he said, well, warn them. And I said, okay, I'll do it. And I tell you, when I first did it, I was like, okay, I got to do this. But I did it. Second time I did it, you know what I mean? Walking in faith, man. And I honestly, you know what I mean? Like I said before, no one is going to be there for you. No one's going to be there for you when you're standing at the judgment seat. And I don't even want to make this, you know, a judgment thing, but I'm telling you the truth. You're going to be there on your own. And the Lord says, love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, mind, and soul, and everything in you. So how can you say that you truly love him with everything if you are afraid of telling who you are to someone? It would literally be me walking around and saying that I'm not black. You know what I mean? I'm not African-American. Now, I don't stand in that because I stand in Christ, but I'm just trying to give you guys an example. It would literally be saying, you know, no, I'm not black. You know what I mean? I'm Asian. And they go, what's wrong with you? Like, why are you ashamed of who you are? And I'm not ashamed of who I am, nor you should not be ashamed of who you are. Your words, your actions, your belief, your faith is what is either going to bring you home to Jesus Christ or is going to leave you here. Because God is going to give you what you desire. He will give you the desires of your heart. And if your desire is to be tied to this world or to love the opinions of this world or to be in fellowship with them versus God, he'll leave you here with them. And you will spend eternity with him. Those of you that hate church, hate singing, hate, you know what I mean, all those around you, why in the world would God bring you to eternity where that's where we're all going to be? He's going to do you a favor. He's going to say the faith that you had in what you wanted, because faith is the evidence of things hoped for. So whatever you walk in, that is going to be your answer of the desire that he's going to give you. Is your desire to be with him? Or is your desire to be with others? Whatever it is, it's going to be your choice. That's it, people. All right. So high rapture watch, end of the day, even tomorrow, man, because of this UFO report stuff and the June 1 and what we just saw with Benjamin Netanyahu and all. Dude, it's very Dana Coverstone's dreams and the homeless guy's dreams about May and kickoff. I'm like, dude, it's very hard to think that we'll get past June 1st. But if we do. If we do, oh, man, dude, from now to June 10th, that June 10th, man, is a serious marker. I see some serious events happening between here and there. So we just stand and watch. Nothing to it but to do it. We also have IR 26 when Jesus, IR 25 and 26, when Jesus ascended to the Father as well, is coming up too. And that is June 6th, I believe. So we're still in the second Passover week. It's a festival week, just like first Passover. So we're still in that to like June 3rd or something like that. So anyway, we stand and watch, man. We're almost home. Nothing to it but to do it. Shalom. Love y'all. Jesus Christ loves you dearly. Have a good one, y'all. Later.